现在我们可以看到月球样品从返回器中取出，在密封罐中保存的就是嫦娥六号在月球背面通过表取和钻取两种方式获得的珍贵月球样品。
嫦娥六号它最初呢是嫦娥五号的备份，但是嫦娥六号任务绝对不是嫦娥五号任务的一个简单的重复，应当说呢，我们不但在人类的历史上首次获得了珍贵的月球背面的样本，而且呢，在整个工程的实施过程中，我们也获得了许多重大的技术上的突破。那么尤其是我们实施了人类历史上首次从月球背面起飞，因为我们知道我们嫦娥六号的上升器，那么它从月球背面起飞呢，要和在轨道上等待的轨返组合体进行交会对接，所以说呢，这就对它的整个的飞行过程提出了极高的精度上的要求。我们只有鹊桥二号中继卫星这样一个有限的技术手段，我们的挑战和难度越大，我们在成功以后我们获得的回报就越大。无论是月背起飞，还是我们的这个自主的这个采样，还有我们的这个在月球轨道无人自主的交会对接，那么这些关键技术的突破和掌握，应当说呢，不但为我们的这个探月工程做出了卓越的贡献，而且呢，也为未来更具备挑战性的，比如说是小行星还有这个火星的采样返回任务，奠定了一个非常好的技术基础。
This is a very challenging mission.Because it was totally robotic, and secondly, this is the first time that any nation or any human beings have recovered these samples from the far side. So there are so many challenges on this one, and so the completion of this project is a great achievement, not only for China, but for the humankind.One particular aspect for this mission is very important is that Chang'e mission is opened up to international payloads also. So this particular mission had four payloads. Among them was our payload for the iCube, and there were three other European Space Agency, one Italian and the French. So you can say it was kind of an international mission.And this is actually the basic theme of this exploration is for humankind. And for us, this was a great experience that we worked with them. And we got a very good experience in terms of collaboration, in terms of getting the results that we got, and our mission success and everything.